In this session, we will discuss how we can read Excel file using NiFi. So I have NiFi started and now I'm just going to create one sample Excel file. So I'm just going to name it student info. And let's create couple of records in this file. So one thing when you are dealing with Excel file in NiFi, so the first thing which you need to do is you need to use a processor which is called convert Excel to CSV processor. And in that processor, we need to define the sheet name, okay, sheet name of the Excel file. So just make sure whatever sheet name you have given, you will be needing that sheet name. Okay, so I'm just going to call it, let's say ID and name, and we'll put number 1 and 2, and let's just put couple of names. So that's all I want here. And if you want to rename this sheet, you can rename. I find it better to rename. Or if you have already some workbook or Excel file which is having different sheet names, so just keep a track of that sheet name. So in this case, I'm just going to call it student. Okay, I'll just call it student. And just remember our main file name is studentinfo.xlsx. So I'm going to save it and then we can exit. So that's all we need in terms of file. Okay, so just keep a track of the sheet name. And now this file is stored at this location. So I'm going to copy this complete path. We'll be needing it. Okay, now let's move to NiFi. Now here, again, whenever you start preparing something, just make sure you do inside a process group. So let's call it reading Excel example. And inside this, let's use convert Excel to CSV. Okay, this is the processor which we need to use. Now let's right click here and go to configure and let's go to properties. Now here in the properties, notice that you have a way to define sheets. Okay, so you have a sheets to extract property, and here, as I remember, my sheet name was student, so I have given student here. However, please notice here, now you do not have a way to specify what is the name of the file. Okay, now the reason is it is not having a place to specify a file because it expects a flow file which is going to come along with the file name. Okay, so that's the reason we need to use any processor which can actually pull the file along with the file name. Okay, so in this case I'm going to use get file. If your Excel file is at a remote location, you can use get sftp. So I'm using get file, and get file I'll be connecting to convert Excel to CSV processor. And now here in the get file, let's right click and go to configure. And in the properties, here in the input directory, we need to define the directory where your Excel file is available. Okay, so in this case, I know we have created our Excel file at this location, so I'm just going to save. And in the file filter, you need to specify the name of the file. So this is the name of the file, studentinfo.xlsx. So I'm just going to copy the complete name from here and let's paste it here in the file filter value. Okay, so that's all we need here. And in the scheduling, I'm just going to make it 600 seconds. And also, if you do not want your file to be deleted from source, you can make keep source file to true. Okay, in this case, I'm just going to leave it to false and then click on apply. Okay, and convert Excel to CSV processor is still giving some warnings because it is expecting relationships to be connected. So I'm going to connect it with funnel. and let's connect each of the relationship separately so we can see what is going on. Okay, so that's it. I think now we are good to start. So let me start one by one. So let's start get file, and then if I right click here and go to list view, here you can see in the file name you have studentinfo.xlsx. Okay, so this is the attribute which is going to be used by this processor. Okay, and then from that file name it will pull this sheet which is student. Okay, so let's run this and let's refresh. Okay, now we have file in the success queue, which means it is successfully processed. In the relationship of original, you have the original flow file. Okay, so the file which was passed from get file success queue, that is the one which you get here, and this is the one which is the sheet which has been read. So here if I right click and go to list queue, now you can see in the file name has been changed to file name and underscore name of the sheet dot csv. Okay, so that is how file name gets changed after it is processed. So now it has been converted to a CSV, and now if I go here in the view content, we should be able to see the content which we had created. So now you can see we have the same data which we had created in the Excel file.